So let's keep the conversation around productivity and that take it straight to our London studios where Juliana Olayinka is standing by for this conversation around the UK's industrial sector. Tata is planning to cut 1,000 jobs, and I'm asking if this is all about the outlook for Brexit. Let's get Juliana in here into the conversation. Juliana, good morning. Talking about Nigeria's productivity and all of that on one hand. This is production and productivity in the UK. Why is Tata shaving about 1,000 jobs in the UK? Is it all about Brexit?
Good morning, Bosun. Well, Brexit and many other reasons, and this is going to be a huge blow to the steel workers in Port Talbot. That's a small town in Wales where they have the majority of Tata's workers. Tata employ about 8,000 people across the UK. The majority of them are at this port. And of course, there have been backwards and forwards, toing and throwing with Tata over years. There were threats a couple of years ago that they would be closing down the plant, but they said they would inject £1 billion into restoring it, which is why a lot of union bosses are so angry at this announcement that they'll be cutting 1,000 jobs, because they say that this has come out of the blue. Tata are saying that, you know, it was completely unavoidable, that the market at the moment is just too unnerving for them to stay exactly the way they want to. They will be cutting 3,000 jobs, and of course 2,000 of them will be on the continent. A lot of jobs will be going in the Netherlands. They have blamed the demand in steel. They said the demand in steel across the EU is dwindling. It's becoming more profitable for global markets to get their steel in China. Also as well, a lot of dirty jobs, so including steel and oil, have a lot of emissions taxes to pay. And they say that's really hit them hard. And as well, China, US, though trade tensions have hit steel manufacturing. So they said that this cost-cutting drive will take place next year. Union bosses, who really are quite fearful in the UK, they've said that this is not to do with any of the reasons that Tata have cited. They think that this has got something to do with a merger that they were supposed to be doing with a German company a couple of months ago. But Belgian authorities stopped the deal at the last minute, citing competition regulations. And they believe that because they didn't have a plan B for that, they're cutting jobs in the UK.
Interested how some of these industrial manufacturing education, or sorry, economic issues will continue to move on along the elections and the Brexit line. But again, very quickly, checking in with the financial markets, what's the problem with Virgin Money reporting not particularly good quarterly earnings?
Well, Virgin Money, they've reported their earnings. They've reported their full-year earnings, which is at a loss of £194 million. We discussed it during the summer, Bosun, this PPI, Payment Protection Insurance, which was a huge scandal in the UK where banks were mis-selling insurance to individuals. That 10-year lapse of being able to claim ran out in August, and Virgin Money say they literally had to put aside all of this money. I think about £350 million. To cover that in Q4. And surprise, surprise, their shares this morning were up 9.4%. And that's because, you know, Virgin Money, they are a very small bank, but they've just done a takeover, a merger with Clydesdale and Riversdale Bank, which is a northern bank, another small bank. And the CEO said, look, you know, we have reported these losses. We know that this has got to do with those one or two single payments. You know, we're really trying to disrupt a market that is, you know, stagnated and stale by these bigger banks. And we see a good future in 2020. And shareholders agree, which is why they're one of the biggest risers at early trading this morning.
Interesting. So where are we with the, let's just check in finally, with the elections. Where are we at the moment? It looks like the Conservatives are making a lead. YouGov poll says they're likely going to win the elections and what have you. Check in with everyone for us. Where are we on the campaign trail?
Well, we're just exactly 2 weeks away. And as you said, the headline is that Boris Johnson, the Prime Minister, the leader of the Conservative Party, will indeed win. He has been, you know, leading the polls since, you know, they started the campaign about 4 weeks ago. But the reason why this has surged the markets, you know, the sterling is up 0.09% on the dollar this morning, is because this particular poll has spoken to 100,000 people. It's the largest poll that's been done. And also they predicted the 2017 hung parliament. So a lot of people are going with this. Of course, Labour have had a torrid couple of days. Anti-Semitism, which has been rife in that party, well, there have been allegations of that. They have come to haunt Jeremy Corbyn. Quite similarly, Islamophobia has also been a big issue for the Conservative Party. So religion has dominated sentiment this week. But yes, the headline is Boris Johnson will get a comfortable majority on the morning of December 13th.
Thank you so much for being part of the program this morning. Keep an eye out on that. Let's talk about what our wrap up the week and the month. Tomorrow is the final business and markets day for November. Then, of course, we can maybe talk about Christmas, shopping, and the Black Friday. Put it all together. I don't know why it's called Black Friday, by the way. Talk to me. Maybe it's a White Friday. I don't know why blacks is appreciated. Just do some dig around that for us. And let's have a happy TGIF tomorrow, Friday, the 29th of November. Thank you so much. Have a great day. Let's take a break, everyone. We're back in two. We're checking with the marketplace when we come back.